Oh yeah, and welcome back and stuff.
Welcome back and stuff. We're gonna go talk to Fledge.
Fledgy Fledge.
Five, six, seven. I just need a breather. Link, what have you got there? Is that a stamina potion? I don't suppose you'd let me have that, would you?
Here, take my Mountain Dew.
Really? Thank you. I owe you one.
Do the do.
Oh, yeah, I could feel my muscles perking back up already. Edward Elric Muscles! You can win! You feel great!
He's saying stuff at the bottom
It's
there.
just that, at this rate, I don't know if I'll ever get strong and burly.
Yes. Yes, you
Link,
can!
you feel great! You can do this!
You can get burly as long as you have the genetics for it.
Wow, really? Do it! It's great to hear you're so confident
Just do
in
it!
me. Maybe I can actually do this!
Just do
Do
it!
it! Make
Don't let
your
your dreams
dreams
just
come
be
to dreams!
dreams!
Make your dreams come true! Thank you, Link. I'll make you proud. You'll see. I'll be super burly in no time. Okay, back to training. Come back soon so I can show you the new me.
Whatever you say, Pikachu cheeks.
Yeah.
Pika cheeks.
Pika cheeks.
Chikachu. Chikachu. Oh, there's nothing more to do at nighttime,
Time to sleep.
until morning. Until the morning light. It's time to say goodnight.
Okay, back to business.
Back to beeswaxness.
Hey, man, when Groose gets sad, he's downright miserable. He's always in his room sulking. When he comes out, he gets angry at everyone for no reason, even me. The way I hear it, you're the one responsible for Zelda going missing. This is your mess. You better. I think we already read this.
Yeah. Sorry, for some reason I thought I had activated something that I haven't yet. But I will soon!
Okay, let's go do something.
Yes, we are going to do something!
Ha! That chest is not activated yet.
No, it is not.
And it's ironically the one we see the most.
Yes, it is.
Where are we going? What are we doing? I don't know.
We're going back to the Seal Grounds to talk to Grandma!
Oh, that's right. They told us to talk to Grandma. Time to fly right into the clouds, butthole.
One of them. These clouds have three holes. Oh my.
Oh, I just remembered. Yes, it's coming. Ah! This is one of my favorite parts.
I think I might have broke his head. Like, seriously, didn't anyone. Like, seriously, didn't anyone ever teach you how to crash, how to land without crying?
Haven't you seen birds before? There were no. There were
Whoa!
no birds on Skyloft. Tiny birds.
Birds! Tiny birds! What are they?
Oh, because he's used to giant birds.
Yes, he's never seen birds. That's. What is that thing? It's just a Goron.
Calm down.
But Where am I? What's going on here? Ever since Zelda vanished, you've been zipping in and out of town and all in a hurry. So I figured I'd tell you, and you might lead me to Zelda. But this is so wild. Seriously, what is that thing over there? And what's with all these trees? There's so many. Just give it to me straight. I can take it. Where are we? Is Zelda here? What's the deal with this place? If there's supposed to be nothing below the clouds, what's all this?
What's this? What's this? There's magic in the air.
Okay, Chris. Now, you see, the thing is, we live on sky, and we live up in the sky, and blah, 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 and surface, and blah, and blah, and crap, and shit.
That face.
Whoa. You're kind of imploding my mind right now. But I think I get what you're saying.
That's a lot of birds.
I've got this right. Zelda's down here somewhere, and she's okay. Yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. She's okay. Oh, wow. That's so great. Duh. Hearing that is such a huge weight off my mind.
Seriously, the birds really like you.
You know, Link, it's sort of all right down here. This place needs a name.
Oh my.
Yeah, a fitting name for this rugged, adventurous wilderness. From now on, we'll call it Grooseland!
They should make a spin-off game called Grooseland for a portable system.
So, let me see if I got this right. The old lady living in the temple down the road knows where Zelda is. I see. Right, Link. Thanks for getting me here. You've done a good job. You can head home. Big Groose will handle the search for Zelda from here. Yep. I'll track her down, save her, and then give her a lift back to Skyloft. Then, when we get back, I'll ask her if she wants to make our whole going out thing official, and then the two of us will get some quality time together. Anyway, the point is your work here is done. I've got it covered from here. Now it's off to the old lady you were talking about.
And off he goes.
Catch you later, Link.
Smell you later. Wow, he's fast. He just disappeared. He's like crazy fast.
That's a blue bird.
Groose is like a ninja.
I scared off the blue bird.
A clumsy, clumsy ninja. Give me the beetle. Aha!
I just walked over it. You can just walk over it.
Walk over it.
If you use a bug net on a blue bird, you can get a blue bird feather. Blue birds show up randomly every now and then.
Sneaky, 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 sneaky!
What the fuck? My net just went right...
It was in the net, dang it.
Fuck it. We got an old lady to talk to, and a boss to fight.
Oh, right.
Yep.
Its first appearance. Well,
yep.
Huh? You gotta be kidding me, Granny! You're messing with me! Say it again! I dare you!
I only speak the truth. You are not the one. Who will save her? The spirit maiden or Zelda can only be saved by another. It has been his fate to do this thing
and in doing so save us. Hence it was decided long before you were brought crying into this world.
Shut it, Granny! You obviously don't know me well, because if you did, you'd know that if anyone's gonna save Zelda, it's Groose! How could it not be me? Plus, if it ain't me, why would I even be here? If I'm not up to the job of being the hero, just who is?
Huh? Afraid that's gonna be me, buddy.
Oh, now I get Link, Granny here has been trying to tell me that you're gonna be the big hero who rescues Zelda. What a joke! Look, all I've heard so far is a bunch of babbling about destiny. I mean, how great can that game even be? But that's a load of garbage. I know you, and you're no hero, shrimp.
Greetings, Link. Were you able to catch up with Zelda? Ah, I see. So the Guardian was there as well, was she? The one you saw by Zelda's side is known as Impa. She is a being sent forth by the goddess to aid Zelda in our quest. Yeah, she's kind of an ass. Oh, don't worry about that. It'll pass in time. I should know. Trust me, I should know.
Are you her grandmother or something?
Something like that. The two have traveled somewhere in order to accomplish a great task destiny has set before them. I didn't even know that game had side quests. However, now that Impa has destroyed the gate that they use, there is only one way left to find them. You must make use of the harps given to you by Zelda. Tell me, Link, have you attempted to play that harp you received? My sense is that you have not yet familiarized yourself with it. Very well, I shall teach you how to play it. Listen well and do as I say. First press up to ready your harp, and then press A to prepare to strum it. What are these weird instructions you people are giving me?
There you go.
Good, you learn fast. Now for your next lesson. Focus and play in time. Play in time with the pulsating circle of light. When your timing is right, I shall join my voice to your harp. Listen well, for the song I sing will be a great help to you in your journey.
It's a circle of harp.
What am I doing, making an alchemy circle or something?
Yeah. Yes, that is the main theme of the game. Well done, Link.
This episode may end up running a bit long.
Not good.
Cinematics and stuff. You learn the battle of the goddess! It's a mysterious melody that's been passed down from ancient times! It's a thing!
A harp you hold is known as the goddess's harp. It's a divine instrument of the goddess who once watched over this land. The melodies it brings to life have the power to produce a variety of strange and otherworldly effects. The great slab standing before you is known as a gate of time. It is the last of its kind in existence, the only portal binding our world to the one where Zelda now resides. If you manage to open the gate and pass through, you will likely end up in the same place as Zelda. But you will need to endure many hardships and put yourself in great danger to awaken the gate from its dormant state. Though your journey will put you in harm's way, Link, you must endure. It is your fate as the chosen hero of the Ga-
Whoa. Granny, what was that?
It's shaking. I fear the seal has been broken. I expected that it would react to your summoning the gate, but I never imagined the seal would break so quickly. Link, there will be time to explain later. Right now, you must hurry to the bottom of the pit outside.
Hurry! We're limited on time! Let's make this fast!
Unfortunately, this is one of those cutscene-heavy episodes.
This had to be the last episode we recorded.
For the day.
Whoa! What's with all of the shaking? Oh, the ground is heaving! I thought it was supposed to be solid down here!
Oh, quickly, Link. Check on the ceiling spike at the center of the pit. There's nothing natural about these tremors. That monster could free itself at any moment. Approach the pit with caution.
Okay, here we go.
Can you tell me how to get to Sesame Street?
Well, can you, motherfucker?
I smell
your
the imprisoned.
Hello, Sesame Street reject.
I knew it. The seal has given away. I'll explain later, but now is the time for action. We must keep the peace from escaping that pit. It must not reach the temple.
Okay, toe attack time. Uh-oh, shockwaves. And the back toes. Alright, there we go.
Oh! Oh! I just wanted to get to Sesame Street.
No Sesame Street for you. Back you go.
Oh, the seal spike. What a pain.
Oh no, it's using its belly movement to move forward.
Ow.
Okay, let's try that again.
Get this thing out! I have a date at Five Nights at Freddy's Part 4!
Seriously, he's got a lot of teeth just like the animatronics in Five Nights at Freddy's 4. Hey, stop blowing up my water balloon toes! They seriously look like water balloons. Okay, seriously, how is he able to stand up even once you've taken out, the second you took out all of his front toes, he should have just fallen. How is the back toes going to give him any stabilities? Stabilities, it's like abilities and stability. Stabilities. Back you go!
Well, this might not turn out to be too terribly long.
Hey, get back here! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh gosh, that guy can really move on his belly.
Ow!
Oh my gosh, can you even outrun that thing? It's like Robotnik after you beat him in Sonic.
Yeah, how was the fat guy able to run so fast? With science, of course!
Skyward Strike! Not quite as effective as I was thinking.
Ow!
Toes! Have to destroy those toes! Water balloon toes!
Ow! Damn it!
Shockwave, and now! The front!
Ah, jeez! The fuck, yeah, man?
It definitely becomes a bit trickier when every single step causes a shockwave.
Ow! This is fucking cheap!
And now! Okay, just one more on that leg. Yeah, one more! Yeah!
Oh! That was getting a bit close.
Hit it in! Hit it in!
I have to wait until I can move.
Dang cinematic. Almost there. No! Camera. Okay.
Got it.
22 minutes.
There's still more cinematic crap after this.
I just wanted to go to Sesame Street!
Skills! Oh, looks like my work
one,
is done.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's way too many things to count here.
2 million skills.
Let's put it back in its place.
Now, Link, strike the ceiling spike with the Skyward Strike and restore the seal quickly.
Okay. Yeah, because we'd never want to do that again, and I'm sure we never will ever have to do that again.
Yeah, down! As in that's the direction you're gonna frickin' go!
You aim for the street, now go into the ground! We can tell you how to get to the Sesame Ground!
You wanted Sesame Street? Well, now you're part of the street!
Yep. Hey, Gross.
Nice going, Link. Though the imprisoned had only just begun to awaken and break its bonds, I'm impressed you were able to restore the seal, keeping it captive. Unfortunately, you have only succeeded in buying us a little more time in which to act. The behemoth you beat back into the confinement is a horror of unspeakable power. Judging by what I saw, I would not be surprised if the seal gave way again soon. So you are left with precious little time to complete the task with which you have been entrusted. Return to the sealed temple, Link. There is much to discuss.
Can we save first, Granny?
You may save inside the temple.
Thank God. Grusad! Bruce actually sounds like a name of a Sesame Street character.
Well, they took me straight back to the temple, only for her to talk to me
as you can see, the gate is nothing more than a slab of cold stone for now. It is sleeping. Rousing it from its slumber would require great power. Yes, I believe a shot from of holy light from your sky would strike might just do it. Alright, Granny, sorry to disappoint you, boy, but for now your sword lacks the power necessary to awaken the gate. First, you and your sword must grow together.
You need to get experience and level up.
Faren Woods, Eldin Volcano, Lanaru Desert, a sacred flame is hidden somewhere in each of these lands. Seek them out and purify your sword in their heat. Only after your blade has been tempered by these three fires will it be fully imbued with the great power for which you search.
This is starting to sound like Wind Waker, Granny.
Yes, but your sword will actually get more powerful and stuff.
And also, those events haven't happened yet.
Clues to finding the sacred flames have been woven into the lyrics of the song precious to your people, the Ballad of the Goddess. These clues are your best hope for finding your way to the flames. Return to Skyloft. Somewhere on your island is one whose knowledge of this old song will point you to the right direction.
What do we? How many dungeons do we have left?
Three.
Okay, I figured because she said three things.
Well, and then there's the dungeon where the Triforce is.
Oh, yeah.
But that's more or less the final dungeon. I usually don't count those.
So we're like halfway through the game now.
Pretty much.
And this is episode, I don't even know, 20-something?
I hate even saying this, but I guess you got it all figured out, Granny. Me? Well, there's nothing I can do to help Zelda. I'm useless. I'm a useless Gruceless.
Ah, you sell yourself short, my friend. You'll see in time that you have your own role to play in all this.
I mean, all I can do is make a giant catapult that flings massive bombs. What good is that gonna do anyone?
Link, go now. Trust in fate to guide your feet. Your mission depends on it, as does Zelda's fate.
What about my hands? Yes, that'll guide your hands too. And my face? Just shut up.
Okay, save. Oh, thank God. Okay, guys, thanks for watching. This is an extra long episode because no one would shut up, and we had to fight a giant monster from trying to get to Sesame Street. So, see you later.
Toodles and stuff, bye.